This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
We're the BBC News at 1 o'clock. This is Jason Kay. Boris Johnson has said that his comment suggesting that he plans to remain in office well into the next decade merely reflected his ambition to implement major reforms to help economic growth. The Prime Minister's words came as a surprise to some in his party because of speculation that he might face a fresh attempt to remove him from office after two by-election defeats last Thursday. But the Northern Ireland Secretary, Brandon Lewis, said Mr Johnson was right to focus on future plans.
We have got somebody who has a proven record of winning elections. There's no getting away from it. It was a difficult week for us last week, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't be getting on with and focusing on the positive things we are looking to do for the country. And that's where the Prime Minister's focus is. I have to say, working with him, whether it's for Northern Ireland or more generally across the UK as a member of the Cabinet, that's what I see his focus on every single day.
The Prime Minister is in Germany attending a G7 summit. He and the leaders of other major industrialised economies are expected to increase support for Ukraine and ban imports of Russian gold. They'll also discuss the rising cost of living affecting people across the world. At least 20 young people are now known to have died in a nightclub in the South African city of East London. The bodies have been taken to mortuaries where post-mortems will be carried out. Our correspondent Shingai Nyoka says it's unclear how the victims died.
Eyewitnesses, some of them that were in the club, say that they just saw people fainting. Reporters that are at the scene right now say that bodies were strewn all over the floor, on the tables, as well as on the chairs of this two-story nightclub. And it seemed as if they were sleeping. There's a suggestion that they might have died from some form of poisoning, from some form of gas.
The SNP MP for Glasgow North, Patrick Grady, has resigned his party membership because of a police investigation into sexual harassment allegations. Scotland Yard is looking into an incident at a pub in London in 2016. Mr Grady will now sit as an independent. Trade unions have accused the government of misleading the public by insisting it doesn't have a role in negotiations to prevent further rail strikes. The TUC said it had commissioned an independent legal opinion which found that the Transport Secretary, Grant Shapps, had very extensive powers over what could be agreed and very significant contractual power to direct how industrial disputes are handled. The Chief Executive of Network Rail, Andrew Haynes, says the problem is that the RMT union is blocking modernisation.
I'm very keen, for example, to pay a decent pay rise to my colleagues. But with a £2 billion financial deficit, the best way to do that is to modernise and be more efficient. If we can't fund pay rises through productivity, then we either have to ask the taxpayer for more money, and I don't think that's really credible in the current context, or we have a decline in railway.
And the weather, western areas will have outbreaks of rain, cloud will spread eastwards, bringing some showers, and the southeast should remain dry. That's the BBC News, just coming up to 3 minutes past one.
The world!
You are the light of the world!
But if that light's under a bushel, it's lost something kind of crucial.
You've got to stay blind to be the light of the world.
You are the salt of the earth.
You are the salt of the earth.
But if that salt has lost its flavor, it ain't got much in its favor.
You can't have the salt.
Let's have some wine!